तेरे बिना All praise and all thanksgiving. As the Lord has come to our midst, let us pay homage and honor to Him by an arati. Loving Father, Creator of the universe, you are the supreme ruler and master of times and ages. Together with the angels and saints who sing your glory day in and day out, we join today to offer you our adoration and worship. Dear sisters and brothers, we are in the presence of the Eucharistic Lord. Let us experience His presence within us, around us, and especially in the Blessed Sacrament of the altar. Let us worship Him. Let us look at Jesus. Look at the face of Jesus. Yes, Lord, these past few months, the suffering caused to humanity due to COVID-19, natural calamities, families are affected by divorce, suicidal cases, global warming, climate change, riots, youth who are affected with the drugs, alcoholism, and other bad habits. Lot of suffering caused by the use of modern technology like Facebook, YouTube, website, and Twitter. Today, Lord is telling, "Here I am to heal us." Our Lord is here as a healer. He says, He became a bread for us. Dear friends, let us welcome Jesus in our brokenness. Let us welcome Him in our tiredness. Let us welcome Him in our doubts. Let us welcome Him in our pain and aches. He got the power over all the sicknesses. He knows our trouble. He knows what is wrong in the world. At this moment, we are invited to enter into the heart of the Father and taste the depths of His mercy and tenderness. Yes, dear friends, our God is God of mercy and compassion. It is mercy that made Him become Emmanuel, God with us. It is mercy that raised Him up on the cross and died for us. It is mercy that makes Him to remain hidden in the little white horse, hiding all His divinity and greatness. God's power is flowing into every one of us. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Now let us kneel and pay homage and adoration by praising Him and thanking Him. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
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 Worship you, Jesus.
Worship you, Jesus.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
Adore you, Father.
Adore you, Father.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Adore you, Father.
Adore you, Father.
Worship you, Jesus.
Worship you, Jesus.
Worship you, Father.
Worship you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise you, Lord.
Praise you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Chapter 8, verses 1 to 12. Then each of them went home, while Jesus went to the Mount of Olives. Early in the morning, he came again to the temple. All the people came to him, and he sat down and began to teach them. The scribes and the Pharisees brought a woman who had been caught in adultery, and making her stand before all of them, they said to him, "Teacher, this woman was caught in the very act of committing adultery. Now, in the law of Moses, commanded us to stone such women. Now, what do you say?" They said this to test him, so that they might have some charge to bring against him. Jesus bent down and wrote this with his finger on the ground. When they kept on questioning him, he straightened up and said to them, "Let anyone among you who is without sin be the first to throw a stone at her." And once again he bent down and wrote on the ground. When they heard it, they went away, one by one, beginning with the eldest. And Jesus was left alone with the woman standing before him. Jesus straightened up and said to her, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" She said, "No one, sir." And Jesus said, "Neither do I condemn you. Go your way, and from now on, do not sin again." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you? No one, sir. Neither do I condemn you. Go your way, and from now on, do not sin again. Neither do I condemn you, and from now on, do not sin again, said Jesus. We need to hear these words of Jesus often in our lives. Wounded as we are with criticism, sicknesses, beaten up and broken by condemnation in many ways that exist in the society today, these words are so very consoling and comforting to us. Jesus understands our human frailty and fickleness. How relieved was the woman to hear these words? Dear friends, God's merciful love has the power to dispel that darkness that exists in each one of us today and in the society around us in which we live. Jesus, Lord, we want to say in this hour of mercy, as we have gathered in your name, Lord, we love you. A loving Savior, your mercy cannot be separated from your love. You are love, Lord, and your nature is mercy. Mercy triumphs over judgment. Lord, in your love, there is only mercy. Mercy that looks beyond all our negative spirits. Lord Jesus, help us to come out of our negative spirits that is within us, our sinful nature, Lord. Right now, we surrender at your feet. As we offer ourselves, we surrender this world of today, this suffering humanity around us, so that we will be able to experience, Lord, the sweetness of your mercy. Lord, you saved us not because any works of righteousness that we have done, but Lord, according to your mercy. King David said, "Let us fall into the hand of the Lord, for his mercy is great, but not into human hands." Lord, your hands are full of mercy. Give us, Lord, your grace to fall into your safe arms so that we will not be attacked at any moment by any powers of darkness. Merciful Lord, you look upon us with kindness even today. Your compassionate heart continues to reach out to us and offers us to lift up the burden of our sins. You are present with us, Lord, through our family, our friends, our neighbors, and in the suffering humanity of today, and the sacraments to mediate your grace to us. Merciful Savior, every day you do come and stand in the midst of us, desiring to show us that you are our Lord and merciful Savior. You want to take away our sins, our fears, our doubts, and forgive our every sin, and to experience your mercy. Every day you want to open to us, Lord, more and more, to experience your love and blessings. God's mercy is the foundation of our lives, a mercy that is new every morning, a mercy that will never end. Lord, you have called us to comfort and console every person on this earth. We acknowledge with all our humility, Lord, it is our responsibility to give you to others, to give your name, Jesus, to others, to the downtrodden, to the broken ones of the society, and to the suffering. Today, Lord, the world is in need of your healing mercy. O merciful Savior, give us your grace to listen to your voice each and every moment and all that happens in our surroundings today. Lord, it is your mercy that has given us this grace to stand before you. We acknowledge, Lord, like the sinful woman who was helpless in the presence of her accusers because she fell into your trap and so she was saved. Lord, we are here in her name, representing her. You call each one of us by your name right now. Jesus, Lord, accept our prayers. And as we listen to your comforting words, we lift up to you, Lord, the people who suffer with this pandemic during these days. The families that are, Lord, left orphaned. The families that are in fear, tension, anxiety, and worry. Lord Jesus, our merciful Savior, we lift up to your loving hands all those who come forward in your name to serve them in one way or the other. Lord, you know everything we do not tell to you. Listen to us, O merciful Savior. Let our response be, Father, I thank you for hearing me. I know that you always answer my prayers.
Father, I thank you for hearing me. I know that you always answer my prayer.
Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be afraid, for I am your God. Response.
Father, I thank you for hearing me. I know that you always answer my prayer.
Do not fear, I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my victorious right hand. Father, I thank you for hearing me. I know that you always answer my prayers. Do not fear, my child, for I, the Lord your God, hold your right hand. It is I who say to you, do not fear, I will help you.
Father, I thank you for hearing me. I know that you always answer my prayer.
Do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name, you are mine.
Father, I thank you for hearing me. I know that you always answer my prayer.
When you walk through the waters, I will be with you. And though the rivers, through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you.
Father, I thank you for hearing me. I know that you always answer my prayer.
When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burnt. No flames shall consume you.
Father, I thank you for hearing me. I know that you always answer my prayer.
It is the Lord who goes before you. He will be with you. He will not fail you or forsake you. Do not fear or be dismayed.
Father, I thank you for hearing me. I know that you always answer my prayer.
Do not be afraid. You are more valuable than many sparrows. Father,
I thank you for hearing me. I know that you always answer my prayers.
இந்த நிலையில் நான் இருந்தாலும் என்னை வெறுக்காதவர் என் இயேசு ஒருவரே என் தேவன் ஒருவரே எந்த நிலையில் நான் இருந்தாலும் என்னை வெறுக்காதவர் என் இயேசு ஒருவரே என் தேவன் என் பாவங்களை சொல்லி சொல் பரிகசிப்பார்கள் எந்த நிலையில் நான் இருந்தாலும் எந்த நிலையில் நான் இருந்தாலும் என்னை வெறுக்காதவர் என் இயேசு ஒருவரே என் தேவன் நடுவரே என் தேவன் நடுவரே எந்த நிலையில் நான் என் இயேசு ஒருவரே என் தேவன் நடுவரே பட்டம் படிப்பு இல்லாவிட்டால் பலர் வெறுப்பார்கள் பட்டம் படிப்பு இல்லாவிட்டால் பலர் வெறுப்பார்கள் வெறும் பட்டமரம் என்று சொல்லி பரிகசிப்பார்கள் பெரும் பட்டமரம் என்று சொல் பரிகசிப்பார்கள். எந்த நிலையில் நான் இருந்தாலும் எந்த நிலையில் நான் இருந்தாலும் என்னை வெறுக்காத எந்த நிலையில் நான் இருந்தாலும் என்னை வெறுக்காதவர் இன்னேசு ஒருவரே என் தேவன் நடுவரே. என் அன்பு வேண்டுமா என்று அலைய வைப்பார்கள். என் அன்பு வேண்டுமா என்று அலைய வைப்பார்கள். அனாதையாய் நான் இருந்தால் பலர் வெறுப்பார்கள். அனாதை நான் இருந்தால் பலர் வெறுப்பார்கள். என் அன்பு வேண்டுமா என்று அலைய வைப்பார்கள். என் அன்பு வேண்டுமா என்று அலைய வைப்பார்கள். எந்த நிலையில் நான் இருந்தாலும் எந்த நிலையில் நான் இருந்தாலும் என்னை வெறுக்காதவர் என் நேசு ஒருவரே என் தேவன் நடுவரே என் தேவன் நடுவரே. எந்த நிலையில் நான் இருந்தாலும் என்னை வெறுக்காதவர் என் நேசு ஒருவரே என் தேவன் நடுவரே. எந்த நிலையில் நான் இருந்தாலும் என்னை வெறுக்காதவர் என் நேசு ஒருவரே என் தேவன் நடுவரே.
Dear friends, now let us feel sorry for the time we have given pain to our beloved God by our own thoughts, words and deeds. Fail to see His presence in our neighbors and fail to extend our helping hands to them. Your response shall be, Lord, we come humbly before you today, asking that you forgive us for when we have not obeyed your commandment to love others as you have loved us. Forgive us for the times when we have despised wisdom and instruction, and we have not done unto others as we would like for them to do for us. Response.
Hear your people, have mercy, O Lord.
As the saying goes, a family that prays together stays together. Today, we see that the values are lost and relationship is broken. No peace and harmony among the family members. Lord, this happens because of our negligence to stay together and maintain the spirit of unity. Lord, restore the families again in your great mercy. Forgive us, O Lord.
Hear your people, have mercy, O Lord.
One of the most beautiful gifts of God to the world is the youth. Lord, we see that many young people are today attracted by new idols such as consumerism, well-being at any cost, moral permissiveness, violent protest, addiction to various things. They refuse to obey the church, the commandments and elders. and find satisfaction nowhere. Thus get into depression and despair, and many end their life even. Forgive, Lord, this evil of the world, and restore all the youth to your love. Forgive us, O Lord.
Hear your people.
Jesus, our good shepherd, you have called the priests and religious and entrusted to us a particular mission. But Lord, for many times, we have not really understood our mission and responded to your call worthily. Wipe away all the errors and restore us again in your great mercy. Forgive us, O Lord.
Jesus, our Divine Master, today the world is behind power and possession and all evils of this world. It has forgotten the Creator. The COVID-19 pandemic has taken entry into the world and has brought much destruction. But still, we fail to come to you in our knees and ask for help and forgiveness. Restore us and build us again, O Lord.
Hear your people, have mercy, O Lord.
God, our Creator, you have created the world beautifully and handed over to us. But we, by our manpower, destroying the world, and nature is revolting against us. The natural calamities have brought destruction around the whole world. Forgive us in your great mercy and restore the nature into its original beauty you gave. Forgive us, O Lord.
Hear your people.
As we have placed all our needs, the sins that we have committed, let's feel sorry for all of them. And as we are going to recite this mercy chaplet, let's offer for our whole nation, more especially all those who are suffering from different natural calamities, that the Lord may show His mercy and kindness upon all of us.
You expired, Jesus, but the source of life gushed forth for the souls, and the ocean of mercy opened up for the whole world. O fount of life, unfathomable divine mercy, envelop the whole world and empty yourself out upon us. O blood and water, which gushes forth from the heart of Jesus, as a fountain of mercy for us, I trust in you. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Eternal Father,
I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, in atonement for our sins and those of the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
Eternal Father,
I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, in atonement for our sins and those of the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world. Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, in atonement for our sins and those of the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, in atonement for our sins and those of the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, in atonement for our sins and those of the whole world.
Yeah. परिशुद्धराय देवमे परिशुद्धराय बलवाने परिशुद्धराय अमत्यने ഞങ്ങളുടെയും ലോകം മുഴുവന്റെയും മേൽ കരുണയായിരിക്കണമേ പരിശുദ്ധനായ ദൈവമേ പരിശുദ്ധനായ ബലവാനേ പരിശുദ്ധനായ അമർത്യനേ ഞങ്ങളുടെയും ലോകം മുഴുവന്റെയും മേൽ കരുണയായിരിക്കണമേ പരിശുദ്ധനായ ദൈവമേ പരിശുദ്ധനായ ബലവാനേ പരിശുദ്ധനായ അമർത്യനേ ഞങ്ങളുടെയും ലോകം മുഴുവന്റെയും മേൽ കരുണയായിരിക്കണമേ
Eternal God, in whom mercy is endless and the treasury of compassion inexhaustible, look kindly upon us and increase your mercy in us, that in difficult moments we might not despair nor become despondent, but with great confidence submit ourselves to your holy will, which is love and mercy itself. Jesus, you are the wounded healer. Heal me by your wounds, forgive my sins and those of my forefathers. Through your bloodshed, fill me with your Holy Spirit, by the power of your resurrection. Amen. Lord, I consecrate my family members, myself and my dear ones, into your Eucharistic heart and the Immaculate Heart of Mother Mary for great transformation and miracles. Amen.
Let our response will be, in your mercy, Lord, hear our prayer.
In your mercy, Lord, hear our prayer.
Jesus, our Good Shepherd, we pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, bishops, priests, and all the religious. Sustain us by your gracious and blessings, so that we may be faithful servants till the end. Lord, guide and protect us from all evils and dangers of the present world situations, and safeguard us from this deadly virus, COVID-19, while we assist our brothers and sisters, we pray.
Lord,
in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for people who are infected with COVID-19 pandemic and are in quarantine. Jesus, during your ministry on earth, you showed your power and care by healing people of all ages and stations of life from physical, mental, and spiritual ailments. Be present now to people who need your loving touch because of COVID-19. May they feel your power of healing through the care of doctors and nurses, we pray.
Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for the suffering humanity who are in fear, anxiety, and feelings of isolation or depression. Give them a sense of purpose and hope in your protection. Lord, safeguard their families and friends and bring peace to all who love them, we pray.
Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for the protection of people who are at higher risk of developing the disease. Dear Lord, we lift to you our concern for people who are more likely than others to become severely ill from COVID-19, the elderly, and people with various health issues. Protect them from harm and be their comfort in their time of uncertainty and their isolation from loved ones, we pray.
Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for medical professionals, caregivers, and researchers. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Lord, inspire and invigorate the research doctors developing better tests to diagnose the virus, create vaccines to prevent it, and identify protocols to eliminate the disease's spread, we pray.
Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for the world leaders and other people who are responsible to us. Father, we seek your wisdom daily. Be with people making decisions that affect the lives and futures of our families, communities, countries, and the world at large. We pray that they communicate clearly, truthfully, and calmly with each other and with the public, and that their messages are received and heeded. May truth and empathy be the touchstone of people setting policies for our protection, we pray.
Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for the grieving families who have lost their beloved ones due to COVID-19 pandemic. Lord, we pray that they may experience the nearness and compassion from the Lord, that they may be able to accept the reality of life with faith and hope, we pray.
Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Lord, we are assured of your infinite love for us. We know that even if our sins are like scarlet, your forgiving mercy cleanses our souls and makes them white as snow. All forgiving Son of God, thank you for forgiving us. Your love for us is immeasurable. We give thanks for your marvelous and wonders that have rendered this earth and our lives beautiful. Heavenly Father, we are weak, but you are strong. We bring before you hearts that are in constant need of your mercy. Pour out your mercy and fill us, so that at all times we may implore the mercy of your Trinitarian Self. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Senses can all grasp it.
God, the Holy Spirit, triune God, and be adored. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament has left us a memorial of thy passion, grant, we beseech thee, that we who venerate the sacred mysteries of your body and blood in such a manner as to experience continually in ourselves the fruits of your redemption, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.